Good morning, sir. Drop your name. NG Road, huh?
Sir, your pickup was good, but other passengers, they booked cab.
I called them from pickup location, but they are having breakfast. I wait for 5 minutes, and then they call asking where cab is standing. I tell him, I am near State Bank. He says, which State Bank? State Bank of India or State Bank of Mysore? Now you tell me, sir, should I drive cab? Or should I keep track of banks on the road? And some of these passengers, all the time they are talking on the phone to boyfriend or girlfriend or wife or husband, I don't know. They are telling things I cannot be hearing. But what to do, sir? This is my job. Sometimes they are shouting. So I play radio. But they say, turn off the radio. I can't concentrate. Now, how to tell them I cannot concentrate when they are talking so loudly in the backseat? And sometimes they are couples. Hard to understand, sir. But both are sitting quietly like this. Then, the man gets a call. Then the woman also gets a call. Then I get called. And then both shout at me saying, why are you talking on the phone? Now listen, I understand. But traffic police is not here. So why to worry? Yes, sir. What? Honking? I should honk more, huh?
Okay.
Okay, no honking. Okay, sir. But why honk? Sir, I've got practice. No, daily I'm honking. This is India. No one is looking at indicators. Everyone is rushing. Even at red signal, car behind is honking.
So I also have to honk at the car in front.
In foreign country, they drive in lane. Here, no discipline. See that bi fellow there. Without helmet he is driving. Cutting like this and that. What will happen to parents when they see his body cut up after accident? No patience, sir. Okay, sir. Drop his cup. Give 5-star rating. Okay, the second one is about, again, I have been writing a lot about my journey here in Bangalore. So this is about a jackfruit tree which is outside my house and something I saw last year. And I hope you guys connect with it. So it's titled Fruits and Raiders. A jackfruit tree stands across the street outside my transient home here in Bangalore. Its fruits have turned black. I'm guessing the insides have turned overripe too. It wasn't always this way. Some months ago, while I stood in the balcony, basking in that rare, warm Bangalore sun, three boys, all on the brink of puberty, stood below the then ripe jackfruit, plotting to get their hands on them. The skinniest of the three appeared to have taken on the role of principal architect and directed one of the other two how he was to scale the tree and pluck the fruit. The third he decided to keep watch, looking out for the old uncle on the road, who would turn up any moment, driving them away to the street. Now, just as Mr. Climber had rolled up his sleeves to his elbows and his pants to his knees, the villain of the piece made his appearance. Clad in a vest and lungi, the old man seemed older than Mr. Architect might have anticipated. He did not carry a stick. He just strode out and yelled at the tree. As the would-be thieves made their getaway, he got out of his scooter and chased them till they disappeared around the corner of the street. The fruits remained glued to the tree, undisturbed, drying further as the months went by. I think they will fall off by themselves any day now, and we will not be able to tell them apart from stones on the floor. In another month, the tree will bear fruit again. I wonder, those boys will turn up once more, perhaps timing the execution at a more opportune moment. Maybe when the family is away on vacation, or when grumpy old man is lost watching television, or when he is having his afternoon siesta, maybe he will assemble a bigger gang. Maybe they will not come again. Maybe the tree and the house will wait again till the fruits turn black. Insides, yellow and puffy soft, may never see the light of